Hi, I'm Kate Johnson from Heritage Business Services. I'm here to do a quick video to explain how you would handle it if you accidentally spent personal funds for a business expense and that you needed to input that expense in your FreshBooks account. That's what this tutorial is going to be about. It's not all that uncommon. One of the things I've faced recently is buying something on Amazon and not switching my card, and so it goes to my personal card, not my business card, and I want to get that on my business books, but it's not going to be imported via my bank feed because it's not in the bank account. And you definitely do not want to connect your personal account just to get that expense in there. Don't connect your personal accounts at all. So we are here in a demo account that I have. We're going to go to expenses, and then you're going to add new expense. So let's just make one up here. Office supplies, this was from Amazon, printer, paper, and let's say it costs $15.98. This is just regular office supplies, so you don't need to change anything here. If I had the receipt, I would select it here. This is just an example, so I'm not going to do that. Save. So we see the expense is right here. We also see it right here. Here's the thing, it's not being properly recorded on the balance sheet. So whenever you have put personal funds into your business, that's like, depending on your business structure, but likely that will be an owner's contribution. It might also be called a shareholder's contribution if you're an S-Corp. Whenever you take money out, that's an owner's draw. So if you accidentally buy something from Amazon on your personal card, if you buy something from Amazon on your business card, you'll need to do the reverse of this. You're needing to put that as a, not mark it as a business expense, but you need to mark it as an owner's draw. But for now, we're going to just work through this example of accidentally using personal funds to make a business expense. So I'm coming down here to the report section. So that expense is sitting in the income statement as a business expense, but I want to go to the general ledger. This is the general ledger just for October. That's the only expense that's in here for the month of October. And the debit is the expense for the office expenses category, but the credit is for petty cash, and that's not correct. So we want to keep our petty cash account clear and only containing those transactions that are waiting to be reconciled, and that'll also prevent the cash parent account to not be overstated on the balance sheet. So the way to do that is with a journal entry. You have to have accountant access to be able to do the journal entry. I have made a video about how you can get an accountant account. You can invite someone like me who does this as their living and who helps all sorts of people on FreshBooks, but you can also just use a different email address and invite that email address as an accountant user. So now we're gonna go in and make the journal entry to fix this and properly categorize it as a owner's contribution or a shareholder's contribution rather than having the credit account be for petty cash. Just to be really clear, so we're here in accounting, you can go to the chart of accounts or you can go here, and where it says more actions, if you have a normal FreshBooks business account, you do not have another item under here that says journal entry. And so by inviting an accountant user, which I have that other tutorial to tell you how to do, you have to have the accountant access to make the journal entry. So I'm going to switch accounts to the accountant user account for this demo company and make the journal entry. So I'm in here now to the demo company, Redtex Consulting, and I am going to go to accounting, scroll down to chart of accounts, and I'm going to add a new journal entry. We can name this moving Amazon expense from petty cash to owner's contribution. You'll put it for the, so if this only happens one time, you can put it for the same date. If this happens a couple times a month, and then you look at that petty cash account and you realize, oh, maybe there's three or four transactions for expenses that you entered that you accidentally made. Maybe you pay for stuff in cash. You know, maybe you're paying for parking. You could total it up and make a single journal entry and call it, you know, moving expenses paid for with personal funds for October or something like that. But we'll do it for this date and not wait till the end of the month. Just copy that. And we are going to want to debit petty cash and credit. Not letting me search, sorry about that. We're going to credit owner's equity. It was $15.98. So what's happening? We need to increase our petty cash balance, and then we need to also increase our owner's equity account. We've put more equity into the company by making this purchase. So we're going to come back here to reports. I'm going to scroll down to general ledger and show how now the petty cash account is back to zero, which is where it should be. And the adjustment equity, owner's equity has increased because equity accounts have a credit balance, has increased by $15.98. And then we still have this expense. And all of the, this happened, these are the three transactions that happened on October, in October. That's all that's showing up in this particular demo company. So I hope that was helpful. Again, this is not the process for what happens if you accidentally buy something personal with your business account. I'll hopefully make another video about that soon. So make sure you subscribe to the YouTube channel, as I'm planning on generating a lot of content about FreshBooks to help you get your bookkeeping in order. If you need help, if you're ready to have someone else support you in this, please reach out for a free consultation. I'm happy to talk with you, see if I might be able to serve you. You can go to my website, heritagebusinessservices.com/contact, and book an appointment right there. My calendar is available. I hope this was helpful. If you have any other questions, please leave them in the comments below. It'll help me know what videos to make to help you on your journey as you're trying to DIY your bookkeeping until you're ready to outsource it. All right, again, I'm Kate Johnson from Heritage Business Services, and I'm here to help you build your business legacy.